Saint John Calabria said, "All the world belongs to God." My brothers and sisters of the Calabrian family, I would like to share with you the experience that we had together with the delegate of Philippines, Father Rey, when we visited Papua New Guinea. Papua New Guinea is a small point in the Pacific Ocean. It belongs to the fifth continent, the continent of Oceania. Saint John Calabria said also that the spirituality of the congregation of the opera will reach until the end of the earth. So we have this experience, and that's why we like to share with you in order to help each other to do a proper discernment and how to look forward in the future, and we can establish there our mission with our spirituality. So in this video I would like to show you some images and to see concretely what is this mission about, why we are there in this land to see how the providence was showing us this place in order to think in the future maybe to establish a mission. It should be a dream, a particular and a special dream, if in the future we can reach with the spirituality of the congregation this mission. It's in this spirit, my brothers and sisters, that I would like to share what we have heard, what we have lived, what we have experienced during these days together with the delegate when we visited this land, the land of paradise. We reached the capital of the Papua, Port Moresby, and from there we fly to Rabaul. Rabaul is a part of an island, a big island, called New Britain Island. In this island exists this diocese, and the bishop of this diocese is inviting us to see the possibility to establish a mission. But we were not living there in the capital, because in the past Father Luciano and Father Rey visited already this place. We went in the interior of the diocese. We went in the midst of the forest. We visited a province where there are four parishes in order to know this reality. We found there in this province four parishes well established, with the churches, with the schools, with the pastoral centers and health centers, all organized by the dioceses, and is a field, open field, for education, evangelization, and human promotion. The people is living in a very simple way. They are living there in a very simple way. There are not roads, the transportation is very, very difficult, but they are very simple, very open. Majority are Catholics. There are not so many religious congregations. There are a few priests, diocesan priests, and is a very, very poor, the local clergy. That's why the needs are very much, and in these places we can feel also big structures, but not people to carry out and to give assistance and support to all these people who are living there. Now we'll see some images from these places that we visited in order that maybe your heart may also breathe in the sense that our heart was breathing also seeing and visiting this land. So we visited Pomio provinces, we visited four parishes. The first parish we visited is the parish of Malmal. There is also nearby a small town, Palmalmal, where there is a secondary school. There are 800 students. 500 students are living inside of the school, and they are very open for evangelization also. There in Malmal, there is also a primary school, from the diocese, and the people, students are coming from far, from all the villages far away from there. There are a lot of needs in the educational field. After that, we visited Pomio, the parish. We went by a small boat and we reached this place. The parish priest welcomed us. There is a church, a very nice church. There is a pastoral center. There is also a house for the priest. And the people are very religious. They are very active in the participating in the celebrations. But from there also we visited two parishes in the mountains, in the middle of the forest. The first parish is Mile, and we went there also crossing by other villages, and there are churches very beautiful. We also were asking how they built it, because roads were not there at that time when the churches were built. The Christian communities are big. There are two schools where students are going walking, 3-4 hours walking in order to reach the school. Also, we visited the parish of Nutuve. Nutuve also is in the middle of the forest. The structure of the parish is very deteriorated because they don't have the presence of the priest at this time. The community also is gathering to pray, to celebrate the liturgical celebrations. And there are also other villages where people are living there in a simple way. They are working the field, they are eating what they are producing. There are not roads now. There are building roads because people from outside, companies from abroad, they are taking all the woods that from the forest, and really they are exploiting. They are carrying out of the country all this richness. Also, they are very poor, and people from outside, from abroad, also are taking off all these things, these material resources from these people. After visited this province, the province of Pomio, to see these realities, we went back to Rabaul. We met the bishop. The bishop was very open, and he is open to each one of us to establish a presence in the future for our mission. We visited the minor seminary. We visited also the school where they are preparing teachers in order to send to the farther places in the dioceses. Before coming back to Philippines, we visited the old cathedral destroyed by the volcano, and we visited also the tomb of the first blessed Peter Turot. He was a catechist like San Lorenzo Ruiz in Philippines. He was a martyr, and we pray. We pray in his tomb. If it is the will of God, we may also one day go there in this land to bring the good news of the gospel, the good news of our charism. As a conclusion, I would like to see and to say that the field is open. The bishop is inviting us. The needs are very big. What I see? Two important things. The first one is the spirit of the congregation, the charism of the congregation should reach until the end of the earth. And this is an opportunity to reach with the spirituality of our congregation. But there is another important reason, the diffusion of our spirituality. In some fields that are in the beginning of the opera, to dedicate our life to abandoned children, to dedicate our life to education of the youth, to dedicate of evangelization, to announce, to proclaim the God's paternity among the poor, among the youth, among the people who are in need. That's why we may think about a presence of the opera, presence of the Calabrian family as a religious, brothers and sisters, lay people, to create in this place a prophetic community, as I am telling in the last letter. It should be a laboratory where we can start and transmit the spirituality of the opera in order to live in a simple way the charism of the congregation. What is our intention as a general council? First of all, we are trusting to the discernment of all the Calabrian family, and together to pray and to discern the will of God for us. But in particular way, I call the two delegations, Indian delegation, Philippines delegation, that you have more youth, more people, also geographically you are more close to these places. Also there are many people from Philippines, from India, many religious and priests also giving help to the Papua New Guinea Church. I would like to entrust you especially take care of this mission, to start this mission, of course, with the collaboration of all the Calabrian family in the world. But I would like to encourage you and to see the possibility to establish a mission, to establish a community in that place in order to help this church. So in the future, I invite the two delegates for a visit, maybe now in the month of October or November, with somebody from the General Council to visit again to see concretely the places and where we can establish our presence. But I ask also to share your impressions after seeing this video, to share about some observations or difficulties that we may face if we are opening a mission in that place. But I would like to ask also your generosity. If somebody, in particular way, is called to carry out a mission like this, just to share with me your availability. It is nice if I can get from you some feedback in order to know also your ideas about this future mission. I invite you to be open to the Holy Spirit, to continue to pray that may the Lord show us the way. We cannot leave this opportunity. This is an invitation, a specific invitation, to embrace a new mission, to embrace a new field of evangelization, to embrace a new place where the spirituality of the congregation can reach. And so the Lord will not leave us, and we will not be afraid, because the Lord will give us strength, even though it is a challenge for each one of us. So take courage, brothers and sisters. We are invited to see in the light of faith this possibility, this proposal, in order to reach with the diffusion of our charism. I expect from you some feedback. I would like that your heart also may feel the fire, the enthusiasm, and to be open to this mission. I am convinced that a mission like this will give to our congregation a new enthusiasm, a new passion, and a new vision in order to spread our spirituality. It's in this way that I would like to share with each one of you, and I bless you, and I invite you to pray for this intention.